Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how you can build this hopper-based stopwatch. You can see it right in front of you. So let's start with the specifications of this design here. Basically it's a combination of three different counters. A sub-counter here that counts in 10th of a second. So this means that this thing here has a higher resolution of one redstone tick or 1/10 of a second. Then a main counter, which is this top line of hoppers here, which is good for a total of 64 minutes of runtime. So this is also a very long stopwatch. And down here in this hopper here, basically we have a third counter, which counts the number of times this thing here started since the last time it was reset manually. So let's show how this works. Basically at the back here we have two inputs. The first input is our start input and the second is our stop or pause input. And to start the thing, just turn on this input here. And then you can see the sub-counter moving and the main counter here also counting upwards. Then if you want to stop it, just activate the second input. And now you can start measuring the time. So let's see. In this case we had 14 seconds and 4/10 of a second, so 14.4 seconds for the whole thing to run. And as you can see here, this was the very first run. To reset the entire thing, just turn off the both inputs and then wait a few seconds and the whole thing here will reset. And also a pro of this design is has a very fast reset due to the layout of it and resets in a maximum time of 128 seconds or roughly 2 minutes, which is an advantage if you compare it to several other designs that need exactly as long for the reset as it has run before. So this is also very good for this design here. So anyway, this is basically how it works. Now let's talk about the sizes. As you can see, it's a total of 13 blocks wide, 4 blocks deep, and has a height of 7 blocks. So it's also rather compact for the number of functions it works for. So, and now to the resources. You will need, of course, normal blocks, then 48 redstone dust, a single redstone torch, 34 redstone repeaters, a single redstone block, 2 normal pistons, 3 sticky pistons, 10 redstone lamps, 2 droppers, 35 hoppers. Then I'm using 2 levers as the input. Of course you can use flip-flops or something else. And then the signs, so you know which lamp represents which value. And that's basically all. Although you will also need some items in those hoppers here, which are actually the things you count with. So anyway, that's basically what you're gonna need. So let's show you how to build this stopwatch here. Okay, so the first step is placing a row of 12 hoppers going along like this. Then go below this row with a 1 high gap and place a row of 12 normal blocks below them. Make sure they are full blocks. Then place diagonally a 2 wide platform along the way, like this. Then go to the beginning of your row, so this is the first hopper of this row, and start placing redstone followed by repeaters in an alternating pattern like this. Then on top of this piece of redstone place a dropper facing upwards and then another one facing into this first hopper here. Then you can actually start filling those droppers. Next step is placing a row of hoppers going in the opposite direction, and then you can already also start filling in those with blocks completely. Then place a row of normal blocks like that, and now we basically repeat this pattern from down here.
This time starting with a repeater here, so now the repeaters are on the same height. Then let's go in between. Next, grab a few more hoppers and place them going down like this. This is basically our reset mechanism for the entire thing. So now with the main counter pretty much done, let's go and build the sub counter. For this, first place a row of normal blocks on top of those hoppers here. Then go to the second hopper of this line here and place a lamp above, like this or so. Then four more with one block in between each, like that. Fill in this line with normal blocks. And basically, you build the entire thing once more, just shifted by one block. So in total, we have now 10 lamps. Then let's go to the back here and start placing blocks right next to those lamps here. Then two more blocks at the end here, then below, like so. Next, place repeaters going in this direction at the bottom. One piece of redstone here, and then repeaters in the opposite direction. Come on, until it basically points to this side here, where we put one more redstone. Then it's time for some more blocks, so go at the bottom of those crisscrossing patterns here, out two blocks. So, and for this one here, then put the repeaters facing into the repeaters that are basically going along a circle here. Then redstone behind them, connecting them all up. This is basically our pause button, more or less. Now for the final parts, let's first place a non-stick piston facing upwards there, and another one below it facing downwards. This is to properly update this dropper down here with the redstone up there. Then put a sticky piston facing upwards there with a block on top, block to this side, a repeater on one tick in this direction, followed by a sticky piston right there with a redstone block below it. Then put a block diagonally like so with a repeater on four ticks, run this into a normal block, then place a block down here, put some redstone on top, and a torch there. Next, put a block on top of this sticky piston, redstone on top, then in between those redstones here, basically a sticky piston facing in this direction, followed by a block in front of it, and that's basically the entire thing done. Now we have our two inputs. This is basically our start button, and this is our pause button. So let's give it a try. And as you can see, the sub counter is working, and we are also counting the seconds. So now let's see if the pause button works. And as you can see, now the sub counter has stopped, and our main counter also has stopped. Last part would be actually adding the signs here, so we actually know what those sub counters here mean. And with that, we are pretty much done. All that's left is filling in some spare places at this end here and at the bottom here. And that's pretty much how you can build a high resolution, fast resetting, hopper based stopwatch with a runtime of over a full hour. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!